Now, we come to the use of graphs. What do we have to keep in mind when we're using graphs? Graphs should not be over-cluttered with text. They should be self-explanatory, right? So we have to use graphs only to make important points. And we need to understand that our graphs, again, are a complement to our main topic or our main slide. And we need to put only one major idea on each slide. Now, for example, you can see on this slide also, the main idea is using visuals. And there are no subtopics in the slide, because if you have too many ideas, too many topics on a single slide, or too much of matter, it might confuse your audience. And the chart size must be large so that it is visible. People should not be straining their eyes to be able to try and make out what is there on the picture or the text that is there on the picture. If they do that, then they stop listening to you, right? So you have to make sure that the visual that you're using is not too tiny, that if there's text matter on it, that should be legible, that should be visible, right? And your text matter should be carefully proofread. There shouldn't be any language errors. There shouldn't be any typographical errors, any spelling errors, because that will create a very bad impression. It will show that you have not done your homework carefully, right? So that is about using visuals. And now moving on, what do you need to keep in mind when preparing your slides? Now, this is an interesting one. It's my personal favorite. Let's read this together. It is imperative that one attempts to restrict the complexity of the language utilized to convey one's ideas, lest the audience is bewildered by the ramification of the expression. Now, did you understand anything? No. So what is this? This is extremely complex, extremely difficult language. And you are not supposed to use this kind of language in your presentation. First of all, the language, the text that we use needs to be only phrases or pointers. They need to sound like headlines or titles. You know, you cannot have whole sentences, because that is again going to distract your audience. Secondly, no difficult words. And look at the length of the sentence. It starts from here and it's one single sentence if you pay attention. So it's a sentence of four lines. So this is an absolute no-no. This slide is an example of what you should not do if you want to have an effective presentation, right? So say no to this kind of language use. You have to simplify language. You have to break complicated information into smaller, comprehensible chunks, right? Now, moving on to the structure of the presentation. The structure needs to be simple and use understandable language, which is what we spoke about. There shouldn't be any clutter in terms of color, content, or design. Now, there are people who sometimes use black slides. You know, slides have a black background and then there's green text or there's a fluorescent color background. You have to avoid all of that because these are distractors. A black and white combination is best for slides. Have a white background with black text and one or two visuals to kind of enhance it. Even the titles, for titles you can use another color, but don't use too many colors unless you're color coding something, which is an entirely different thing, right? So even content has to be sparse. There shouldn't be more than 4 or 5 points of reflecting one main topic, describing one main topic on each slide. The design has to be a clutter-free also, right? Then the fonts should be clear and readable. There should not be too much of animation, which is again distracting. And like I said, no more than 5 or 6 points on each slide.